Welcome back to more WCW Saturday Night here on TBS. Attention hotline fans. While new talent is arriving here at World Championship Wrestling, with a few old names returning to the nest, another major wrestling company this past week pink-slipped a considerable number of their staff. Something we can't talk about on the air, but indeed I'll cover tonight during my exclusive hotline report. Plus, there is news regarding Hollywood Hulk Hogan and his knee injury and pending surgery. I've got all those stories and, of course, all of the news from throughout the wrestling world tonight on the hotline right on up until midnight. Pick up the phone right now. Give me a call at 1-900-909-9900. That telephone number again, 1-900-909-9900. It's $1.69 a minute. Kids, get your parents' permission, but do call the hotline right now. Big Saturday night underway. Right now, let's get you up to the ring.
The king of the cruiserweight hill remains Rey Mysterio Jr., but he is in the crosshairs of some of the best wrestlers in the world, Mike, and fighting their way up the cruiserweight ladder. Our next two combatants on Saturday night. First, Evan Courageous.
Well, the king of mystery is the king of the cruiserweight, and I really have never seen such deep talent depth, to quote Yogi Berra, on the WCW cruiserweight roster. It really is the ultimate in deep depth when you think about it, because not only is there the champion, Rey Mysterio Jr., his arch rival, Juventud Guerrera, another former champion, and surprisingly enough, the tag team partner of Mysterio, Kidman, and yes, they will be defending the World Tag Team title belts later tonight, right here on WCW Saturday night, against the former champs, the Horseman team of Dean Malenko and Chris Benoit. Then think about the new WCW cruiserweight talent. And I'm talking about names like Lash LaRue, Mikey Whipwreck.
And of course, the man that brought down the house in Tacoma.
Oh, yeah.
Blitzkrieg.
What a match he had with Juventud Guerrera this past Sunday on pay-per-view. And you're right, this is an opportunity for either this man, Lenny Lane, or his opponent, Evan Courageous, to move up in the standings of the cruiserweights. Let the WCW Executive Committee take note.
Lenny Lane and Evan Courageous going to tie it up on a brand new Saturday night. And I'm really torn, Mike. After the last few years, I can't believe I would actually want to send out good wishes to Hollywood Hogan as he prepares to go under the knife Tuesday in Birmingham, Alabama. But I got to think, everything that Hollywood Hogan has meant to this great sport that I love so much, I don't want to see the man go out like that.
And the other thing is, I have to question, really, the sincerity of Diamond Dallas Page. You saw the match at Spring Stampede.
Yes.
You saw DDP take Hogan's knee, wrap it around that steel post, apply the figure four leg lock. Quick cover now by Courageous, and gets a two count here in the early going against Lenny Lane. And then for DDP to come out on Nitro and to talk about how he wished that Hogan was a part of that four corners match at the finish when he won the world's heavyweight title. I'm not really sure that DDP is shooting straight with us.
I agree fully. If he wanted Hollywood Hogan in the match, he wouldn't have wrapped him around that corner post. But we've seen the World Heavyweight Championship do that to the best of professional wrestlers. And Diamond Dallas Page would just be the latest wrestler that has held the gold, that has absolutely alienated all of his former friends. I see that happening to Diamond Dallas Page. And at Slamboree, brought to you by 1010-220, DDP defends against Kevin Nash.
And what a matchup that's going to be. This is something that Kevin Nash has obviously been working on for several weeks, trying to position himself in place for a world's title shot off the suplex, the cover, and another two count for Evan Courageous. And it seems like those backroom meetings between Kevin Nash and Ric Flair finally paid off for Big Sexy.
They certainly did. And we saw on Thunder, Ric Flair not above just blindly signing away contracts. Who knows what he signed there Thursday in Orlando. Oh, springboard from the top, but Lenny Lane hiding behind the referee, and look at that. Dropped down with the top rope, and Courageous went flying to the ringside area.
That was actually a pretty smart strategy on the part of Lenny Lane. He allowed Evan Courageous to commit himself. Lane drops down, and Courageous goes flying out to the floor. Let's see if Lane can take advantage, and he does. Evan Courageous goes face first into the steel steps.
Please, did you see those steps move? No, you didn't. They don't move at all. just went head first into the. Oh, hang on. Courageous. Reverse. Oh, man. Double leg sweep off the Irish whip, and Lane himself went head first into the other step.
I don't believe I've ever seen that move before where he used a double leg trip, and Lenny Lane ended up face first into the steel and a little wobbly to boot.
Absolutely. He's seeing scars at ringside, and Courageous meets it. But Lane, oh, Lee throttled it. The hot shot over the top steel cable. This is certainly not the high-flying spectacular we expected from two cruiserweights. This is brutal. Ducks the clothesline. Sidekick up top. Body scissors. Oh. No! Inverted powerbomb. Lane cradles it up. Hooks the leg. No. Courageous out at two.
Both of these cruiserweights have been grounded. As you see, the chest of Evan Courageous and the welts developing on his stomach and chest from Lenny Lane. Both cruiserweights grounded because of this brutal physical game of human chess, to quote Larry Zbysko.
Yes. You can't go wrong quoting Larry Zbysko. Lane follows up. He was wasting time there. Courageous out it too strongly, but he may have been primed and ready for a pinfall there, but Lane wasted time. Now Courageous fights back. Look at that uppercut. That rocked Lenny back into the corner. Sets Lane up, shoots him across. Courageous, ran into a back elbow.
Now the inexperience again of Evan Courageous comes to the forefront. He ran in too quickly, and Lenny Lane just put the elbow up and caught him right in the face.
Full scoop and a slam in the center of the ring, and drops the leg. Nice follow-up, quickly done. Float over, lateral press, no. Only got a one count on Courageous. Don't forget, main event still to come. World Tag Team Champions in the house. Kidman and Ray Jr. take on Benoit and Malenko of the Horsemen.
Lying forearm that time by Courageous, goes again for another cover and gets only two. Yes, the Four Horsemen team of Malenko and Benoit want those tag team titles back, and they want it in the worst way. How about that attack on Mysterio this past Monday during his cruiserweight match with Juventud Guerrera? And even when Saturn and Raven came out, Ray wanted no part of them.
He wanted his tag team partner, Kidman, who was nowhere to be seen. There may be more to that story than we know. Oh, reverse clothesline. Nailed Lane in the back of the head, knocked him goofy, or more goofy than he already is. Courageous from the apron. Springboard up top with a crossbody. Put him up in a reversal. Lenny Lane up, cradles both legs, only got the two.
I think it was just at the top of that move off the springboard that Evan Courageous had to hesitate momentarily, and that came back to haunt him. Off the powerbomb attempt, ducks the clothesline.
Up top. Oh, look at that. Driving Lane face first into the canvas. Evan Courageous goes up to the top turnbuckle. Lane is pulling out. There it is. Twisting body press from the top. Hooks the leg.
Taking note, Evan Courageous moves up in the cruiserweight standing.
And still to come on the Saturday night.